What's up, guys? Welcome back. Thanks for joining us today on The King of Random. In the past, we've shown you how to make your very own backyard foundry using a metal bucket and this stuff called kaolin wool. Well, this has worked out great. We've used it for a whole bunch of different projects, and today we're going to try and upgrade and build ourselves a larger foundry using this bigger 31-gallon trash can. The basic principle is that we have our metal trash can, which will contain the heat nicely, but is very conductive and would easily let the heat escape out into the air. So we have this stuff called kiln, which is a very good insulator. It holds the heat in extremely well. In fact, you can put a blowtorch on one side of this and your hand on the other side won't even feel it. I don't think it's even warm after that. So that's the plan. We'll line the whole can with the kiln. That way we'll have the metal container which contains everything, and the kiln will hold in the heat. Now that we know what we're going to do, let's get started. A quick note about the kaolin, it's a fibery substance, a lot like fiberglass, so it's very irritating if it gets on your skin, or especially if you breathe it in. So I'm going to be wearing a dust mask, and that's why I have this long sleeve shirt, so it doesn't make my arms all itchy. There we go, hopefully that'll keep me from breathing in too many fibers. As a first step, I want to add a lining at the bottom of our trash can. I'm going to set the trash can on top of the kaolin, and then trace around that. I'll cut that circle out, and that will go in the bottom of our can. All right, we've got our circle cut out. Now we're just gonna push that down into the bottom of our trash can. Now the kiln is at the bottom of our trash can and that will insulate really well, but it's not a very stable surface if we wanna rest up on it. Here we've got some compressed ceramic fiber board that will work as a stable base. It's a type of board that insulates really well, and since it's rigid, it should be better for standing things on than just the kiln. Now I probably want to cut this just a little bit inside of where I marked, because the very bottom of the trash can is just the tiniest bit wider than the inside bottom of the trash can, I suspect. So we'll have a little bit of play maybe if I cut it too small, but that'll still be better than having it be too big and not fitting. All right, there's a circle. That looks pretty good. Let's see if that fits in the bottom of our can. Ah, it's beautiful. There we go, a nice flat surface. That'll be much nicer than trying to balance stuff on unstable kaolin. All right, now we'll try and take our kaolin and line the entire inside of it. To figure out how much of this kaolin I'm gonna need, I'm just gonna put the whole roll down in the can, and then I'll unroll it onto the sides as much as I can, and then mark where I wanna cut it. Just sort of start with it, one side there. Try and get it nice and pressed up against the sides. Of course, the trash can is not a perfect cylinder, so it is a little bit wider at the top than the bottom. I'm gonna try and account for that. All right, I'm gonna take my marker and mark. I'm gonna give myself some extra that I can later trim off as I do fine tuning without all the weight of the extra kaolin getting in my way in here. Just kind of like that. Now, since the trash can is, like I said, very slightly tapered, ideally our kaolin would have a slight arc to it to fit perfectly around the edge. We're just gonna fake it a little bit by cutting one side at a bit of an angle, and I think we'll get a pretty good fit. So I did the rough cut before. So now I'm going to see if I can get that a little bit more refined. You can see that the edges are overlapping by quite a bit at this point. So this is where one side is, so I'm gonna mark that right there. And the other one is right here. And once again, I am gonna give myself a little bit extra because it's better for it to overlap some than for there to be gaps. All right, let's see how we did. Yeah, it is overlapping just a little bit, which, like I said, is not a problem. Just take some squishing and persuasion. There we go, that's looking pretty good right there. The main body of the can is lined, so now let's quickly cut out a piece the right size and shape for our lid. I wonder if a knife would be easier than scissors, so I'm just gonna try that and see if I like it any better. As you can see, I am leaving an inch wide gap. That's the same thing that we did with our smaller foundry. This way, when we push it into the lid, it will have a little bit of pressure on it and help hold it in place. There we go. I don't think it's gonna compress enough with that extra border I left on it. This lid has an interesting shape to it. There's a lip that extends off of the edge. I think by adding an additional inch to what was already added by the lip, my KO wool is now too wide to fit inside the inner area of this circle. So I'm gonna cut it down just to where I measured it with the marker and see if it fits any better. All right, now we've got our slightly smaller circle. Let's see if that fits into our lid any better. Oh yeah. That's exactly what you want. Being pushed in a little bit, it's not so tight that it won't fit, but it's big enough that it's still got some pressure holding it in. Hey, that's what we're hoping for. And let's give it a try, throwing it on our can. Beautiful, that should be one insulated trash can at this point. Now we've got the walls and the lid covered in our insulating KO wool, and for now it's holding itself on really well. But with our mini foundry, over time, as it got heated up and cooled down and heated up and cooled down time after time, the KO wool lost some of its rigidity and began to slump a little bit. So I've got some hardware and I'm gonna use that to attach the wool to both the lid and the sides of the trash can a little bit so that down the road we don't run into that problem. The machine screw that I'm using here is a little longer than I need, so I might end up replacing it later. That should hold it up pretty nicely. Now I'm going to do the same thing at three points on the lid. Now, no matter how much structural integrity this KO wool loses, it should hold itself on pretty well. It's attached. Now we've got a very well insulated trash can, but no way to add heat. So let's drill some holes into the sides and the lid so we have a place for the propane heat to go in and for some ventilation to go out. I'm gonna try and make the holes in our large foundry at the same height off the ground as the holes in our mini foundry. That way the wooden blocks that we use to support the burners will work at the same height. Plus, if we have anything that's just on the bottom of our foundry, we'll know that it's getting the heat that it needs. That's smooth. Turns out a hole saw is not the very best tool for cutting through very thin steel, but it's what I've got, so let's try it on the other side. Oh, that actually almost went smooth. All right, just as an experiment, let's see if you try and use a hole saw on KO-wool, what happens. Still not perfectly, but much better. With those holes added, I think our full-size backyard foundry is ready to test with heat. Now, I do have a concern that the spacing of the hose with these was designed with the mini foundry in mind, and I'm not positive they'll stretch out far enough to really angle the way we want them to on the large trash can. We'll see what we can do. I think we might be all right. All right, I did get both of them in and slightly angled, but as you can see, the hose is being pulled really tight, and I don't think it's gonna cause any problems for our test, but we'll probably want to add a little bit extra hose before we use this foundry for any extended amount of burning. Whew! That gets toasty quick. You can see that the burners aren't angled quite as much as they should be. That's partly because our hose isn't long enough. So while it is heating it up pretty well, it's not really circling around quite as much as we'd like it to. Let's throw the lid on and let this thing get really warm. hot, hot, hot. All right, I'm just gonna turn it off. It's turned off, but I'm just gonna see. Oh, that is toasty in there. Like the fire's not going, but it's still just really, really warm inside there. There you go. That is how to make a large scale backyard foundry. There are a few different things we're thinking of trying with this foundry. It's obviously much larger than our normal backyard foundry, which is gonna let us do a few more things with it. We'll be able to fit a large crucible, and we also might try firing some ceramics in this forge. I also took some of our leftover K-wool and I re-lined the mini furnace, and I was impressed at how easy it is to do that. It only took me a couple minutes to completely replace the lining. This is a great little furnace you can build and use, and if the K-wool gets so old that it's falling apart, it's very easy to replace in just a few minutes. I'm really looking forward to trying out some experiments with our large foundry to see what it can really do. Thanks for joining us for this project, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. This one's like a Captain America shield, and this one's like a Captain Cotton shield. Not a very good shield.
Hey guys, I hope you're having a great day. You are awesome, you are appreciated, and I know everyone over here on my team is really grateful for you. Thanks so much for choosing to watch and support our videos. We'll see you in the next one.